Just go right to the
Hallelujah! Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Hallelujah.
Let us pray together. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
God bless all love.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, the King of glory, you have exalted your only Son, Jesus Christ, with great triumph to your kingdom in heaven. Do not leave us comfortless, but send us your Holy Spirit to strengthen us and exalt us to that place where our Savior Christ has gone before, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God in glory everlasting.
Amen.
A reading from Acts. In those days, Peter stood up among the believers. Together, the crowd numbered about 120 persons and said, "Friends, the scripture had to be fulfilled, which the Holy Spirit through David foretold concerning Judas, who became a guide for those who arrested Jesus, for he was numbered among us and was allotted his share in this ministry. So one of the men who have accompanied us during all the time that the Lord Jesus went in and out among us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day when he was taken up from us, one of these must become a witness with us to his resurrection." So they proposed two, Joseph called Barsabbas, who was also known as Justus, and Matthias. Then they prayed and said, "Lord, you know everyone's heart. Show us which one of these two you have chosen to take the place in this ministry and apostleship from which Judas turned aside to go to his own place." And they cast lots for them, and the lot fell on Matthias, and he was added to the 11 apostles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read together Psalm 1. Happy are they who have not walked in the counsel of the wicked, nor lingered in the way of sinners, nor sat in the seats of the scornful. Their delight is in the law of the Lord, and they meditate on the law day and night. They are like trees planted by streams of water, bearing fruit in due season, with leaves that do not wither. Everything they do shall prosper. It is not so with the wicked. They are like chaff which the wind blows away. Therefore, the wicked shall not stand upright when judgment comes, nor the sinner in the counsel of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked is doomed.
A reading from the first letter of John. If we receive human testimony, the testimony of God is greater. For this is the testimony of God, that he has testified to his Son. Those who believe in the Son of God have the testimony in their hearts. Those who do not believe in God have made him a liar by not believing in the testimony that God has given concerning his Son. And this is the testimony. God gave us eternal life, and this life is in his Son. Whoever has the Son has life. Whoever does not have the Son of God does not have life. I write these things to you who believe in the name of the Son of God, so that you may know that you have eternal life. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Oh,
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Jesus prayed for his disciples, saying, I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now they know that everything you have given me is from you, for the words that you gave to me I have given to them, and they have received them, and know in truth that I came from you, and they have believed that you sent me. I am asking on their behalf. I am not asking on behalf of the world, but on behalf of those whom you gave me, because they are yours. All mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I have been glorified in them. And now I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world, and I am coming to you. Holy Father, protect them in your name that you have given me, so that they may be one as we are one. While I was with them, I protected them in your name that you have given me. I guarded them, and not one of them was lost, except the one destined to be lost, so that the scripture might be fulfilled. But now I am coming to you, and I speak these things in the world so that they may have my joy made complete in themselves. I have given them your word, and the world has hated them because they do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. I am not asking you to take them out of the world, but I ask you to protect them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. Sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you have sent me into the world, so I have sent them into the world, and for their sakes I sanctify myself, so that they also may be sanctified in truth. The Gospel of the Lord. I speak to you in the name of one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Please be seated. It is graduation time. Of course, graduations last year and this year are a little different than before. And although the reasons for the changes are all about the pandemic, some of the results are okay. On Friday evening, it was my privilege to be the chaplain for one of five commencement exercises that were held by Westfield State University this year. And it only lasted 90 minutes. But let me say first that it is an honor to represent the Albert and Amelia First Interfaith Center at such an occasion of joy. And of course, it is only because of you, because of this congregation here in the center of Westfield, that I am associated with Westfield State's Interfaith Center. You all have made it clear since you called me to serve God with you in this place that our ministry is to our wider community, not just to the 300 or so of us who call this building home. And I am personally grateful for that. And I am also grateful to our music director and Westfield State musician Scott Bailey, who has developed our Choral Scholars Program, which has led to many students joining our choir and our ministry in this place. One of the many sadnesses of the pandemic precautions has been the suspension of the Choral Scholar Program. But, you know, things are changing every day, and we are looking for a revival of the program in the fall. At Friday evening ceremony, I prayed with about a third of the graduating class, a pandemic precaution that made the ceremony much shorter to sit through, and that was nice. But even so, I got to be in the room for the graduation of two of our choral scholars. Jordan Allen and Sam Tsonkalis took their degrees. And although she was not present at the 6 p.m. ceremony, graduate Emily Stratton's pre-recorded singing of our national anthem was spectacular. But you know that because you know how beautiful she sings. Graduations are a way of setting people apart. They say, this person has achieved certain things that others haven't. Jordan, Sam, and Emily now have those letters B.A. after their names. That means that they are educated in the liberal arts and sciences, and they are set apart from those who are not. We set things and people apart in church, too. In religious language, something that is set apart for God is a holy thing. So holy baptism is a special bath, a washing that marks us as part of our life in Christ. Holy Eucharist is a sacred meal, a special way to be nourished by God. Holy, sacred, and sanctified are three different ways of saying the same thing. They are almost like those little letters after one's name that one receives at a graduation. Graduation at Westfield State was different this year and last year too because of the pandemic. And the pandemic has been a time set apart. But in this past week, we all began to realize that we are finally in a new place in this pandemic. It really does seem that it is getting easier to live with the novel coronavirus that has so upset our usual way of doing things. And the operative word in that sentence, of course, is live. As the deadliness of this airborne virus became apparent some 15 months ago, scientists came to the conclusion that as much as possible, we had to avoid shared breathing. So, wear a mask to protect yourself from others' respiration and to protect others from your breath. Keep away from one another at least 6 feet or 20 feet if you are singing. Do not sing or talk loudly in a closed room. Okay, that was the hard one for me. Do not talk loudly in a closed room. And if you have to do any of those things, don't do them for very long. So not only could I not preach loudly, I couldn't preach long. Yay. We begin to live in new ways, a time set apart from the way that we had lived before. This past week, though, the CDC released some recommendations that make us all think that this pandemic time might be winding down. Now, I figured out over a year ago that trying to predict the next thing that is going to happen is a bad job. In the last few days, that bad job has become truly horrible. Vaccinated or fully vaccinated? Masks on or masks off? CDC guidelines or Massachusetts state guidelines? Once again, I am grateful that we Episcopalians work together to decide the details of how we live together. Our bishop, advised by the regional deans, and I have to tell you, I am our regional dean, we have strongly suggested that all of the churches of Western Massachusetts abide by the guidelines as they are set forth by the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. And so, thank you for still wearing masks inside this room, with the exception of when we are standing up to address the people who are at least 6 feet away. And I've measured it. Bonnie Adams is 12 feet away from me. So, we're good. We're maintaining social distance inside. But that's today. Who knows what it will be like next Sunday? Stay tuned. This is truly a time set apart. And although it is hard to call a pandemic a holy time, there is this. Never has there been a time in my life when I have been so sure that my actions can actually ensure the safety of someone else. My choice to stay home when I was exposed to the virus helped to stop the spread of the virus. My choice to wear a mask helps to stop the spread of the virus. My choice to get vaccinated has helped bring us to this point when the CDC is telling us that the time is coming that we can begin to relax the restrictions. For me, and I hope for you too, this focus on the health of others beyond myself has brought me closer to God. Sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth. This is Jesus in today's gospel portion, praying for his disciples just before Judas hands him over to be crucified. Sanctify them. That is, set them apart. Jesus is at the height of his power in these moments just before his betrayal. He has lived a life of sacrificial love. He has shown the healing and the transformation that can come from loving someone more than your own self. He has lived a life of powerful, unbreakable connection to God. And Jesus has shown the people how a life turned toward God impels people to relationship with one another. Jesus has sanctified his life to God. Everything he has said and done in his earthly ministry has been done to show God's glory. And the result has shaken the world. The lame walk, the blind see, the hungry are fed, the self-righteous are furious, the wealthy are terrified, the powerful feel the world slipping through their fingers. Those who have been with Jesus and have shared with him in his ministry have seen the result of a sanctified life. They have seen what happens when people turn to God first, when everything they do is done to show God's glory. What happens is relationship. The ones who love are loved back. The ones with new sight want to share their vision. The ones with new legs want to carry burdens for others. The healthy wear masks, and people run toward a needle in their arm. Jesus begs the Father to sanctify the people. It will not happen in the blink of an eye. It has started to happen already. God the Father has created each person and set each of us apart as the beloved child of God. And yet, when they group together these beloved ones of God, they often forget who they are and who they were created to be. As a group, the individual people become the world, wonderfully interested in their individual delightful achievements, and often woefully forgetful of the God who gave them breath. But Jesus tells us something about truth that we can know at any stage of our educations. Sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth, he prays. And we remember the very first words of John's gospel, the ones we usually hear on Christmas morning. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. God's word is truth, says Jesus. God is truth. When Jesus prays that his disciples be sanctified in truth, he's praying not just for the disciples, but for everyone, everywhere. Set them apart, says Jesus. Let them grow in you. Set them apart to grow in your life. even though the world is about to do horrible things to Jesus, even though Jesus is about to die, he does not ask God to take us out of the world. He asks God to sanctify us in the world. Like education, sanctification is something that sets one apart. And like education, sanctification is something that accumulates. We learn it, we gather it, we grow in it. And like education, we can choose it. We can choose to turn our life toward God. But much, much better than education, sanctification is a free gift of God. We are not sanctified because of our effort. We are sanctified because Jesus makes us holy. Jesus lived on earth and showed us how to live a sanctified life. And he showed us the power of love even as he went to the cross. And now his prayer for us is a life like his, a life full of the abundance of relationship in God. Every time we baptize, we use oil to make the sign of the cross on the person's forehead. You are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever, we say. That sign of the cross is a sign of sanctification, just as clearly as a BA is a sign of education. That sign of the cross is why we call baptism holy. It is the sign of our recognition that God sets us apart to live in the truth. And the truth is that God loves us so much that God trusts us to love one another in God's name. Now I invite you to stand and join with me as we profess our faith using the words of the Nicene Creed. We're at the top of page 7 in our service leaflet. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again. Let us pray for the church and for the world.
Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good.
We offer prayers this morning for all who live in the land of the Holy One.
Death.
Jenny.
Robert.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Bless all those whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, or spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We commend to your mercy all who have died, especially Margaret and Katie Johnson, for whom the sanctuary lamp burns, and Yolanda Rice, recently departed, that your will for them may be fulfilled. And we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Anna. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Sanctifying God, your gift to us is one who overcame the system which enslaves and feeds upon the victim. Send us to your world to speak the truth of peace, to stand with those who suffer, to show another way, through Jesus Christ, the life of all things.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Also
with you. I invite you to offer a COVID sign of peace to one another.
So peace.
Peace. Peace. You can. No, it'd actually be better if you stay here. Thank you. Welcome, everyone, to the Episcopal Church of the Atonement here in Westfield, Massachusetts. If you're here in person, I invite you to be seated. We do have a couple of announcements today. The church is almost as full as it is allowed to be, which is such a lovely thing. But we are also grateful to be with you if you are joining us by YouTube or Facebook, and even we're going to delay a greeting a little bit for some of you who are watching on Sunday evening on Channel 15. We are here at the end of the Easter season. This is the Sunday following Ascension Day. It's that in-between time. Jesus has ascended into heaven and promised not to leave us comfortless. So next week is Pentecost, when we celebrate that day that the Holy Spirit showed up in such an amazing way, with tongues of fire and wind inside a closed room. And we're going to celebrate that by having church outside next week at 4 p.m. We will have an outdoor service. Are you ready? With music! We get to sing outside at 4 p.m., so please bring your own chair or a picnic blanket or whatever you would like to sit on. The service will be probably about 40 minutes, depending on how many people come. And we'll be gathering at the Labyrinth, which is that prayer walk space next to the playground. So that's next Sunday at 4 p.m., weather permitting. So pray for good weather, and there will be activities for people of all ages. So kids, bring your parents and grandparents, and we will have a really good time. We will also have church next Sunday at 8 a.m. and 10 a.m. Our 10 a.m. service is both in person and live streamed. We do ask that you register for services in advance if you can, and if you can't, well, come on and we will try to fit you in. Our balcony is still empty today, so we can fit another 5 or 6 people in here. And who knows what the protocols will be next week anyway. So you got lots of opportunities. Come to church next week.
And wear red.
Oh, thank you, Lois. I thought I said it at the beginning. And wear red. Lois was waiting and waiting. So it is a tradition to wear red on Pentecost Sunday, that color of the fire that lit up the apostles. So wear some red if you can remember, but definitely come to church at 8 a.m. or 10 a.m. or 4 p.m. We will be live streaming at 10 a.m. So if you need to stay safe and stay home, 10 a.m. will be your time. This is the time in the service when we ask you to make a financial contribution if you can. While we are here in person, our current protocols ask that we keep the plate at the door of the church. So if you saw it coming in and put your contribution in, then thank you. On your way out, if you have a financial contribution that you can make, please put it in the plate just outside the door. As you're walking out, it's the door on the left-hand side. Also at that door are baskets to receive food for our little free food pantry. That was a great tradition that we had before the pandemic shut us down, of bringing food with us every Sunday. So if you can start that tradition up again, we would be most grateful. You can also bring donations for the little free food pantry when our office is open. And this week our office will be open Tuesday through Friday, from 9 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. So thank you for your donations to the Little Free Food Pantry. If you are watching our live stream, you will see a list of ways that you can give electronically, and that will be showing up on your screen in just a moment. Now, there are a whole lot of ways to give in the world, and the most important way that we can all give is to get vaccinated. So if you have not yet gotten your shot, and you need help signing up to do that, our program minister, Jess Lee, is a whiz at signing people up to get their shot. If you know someone who needs help getting to their shot, either Jess or I will be very happy to drive you to get that vaccination. Getting vaccinated is the most giving thing that we can do at this moment in our history. Your shots help other people stay healthy and lead to that time when we may even be able to sing together indoors. Yes, please. Know that every contribution that you make, including what you might be able to give today, goes to help this church share the transforming love of Jesus in a broken world. So walk in love, as Christ first loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God. Please stand as you are able. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right, and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through your dearly beloved Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. After his glorious resurrection, he openly appeared to his disciples, and in their sight ascended into heaven to prepare a place for us, that where he is, there we might also be, and reign with him in glory. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love you made us for yourself, and when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And at the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Lord, as I'm
the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Please stand as you are able. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia. Let us go forth into the world, rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Amen.